Welcome. In this video, we are going to discuss about the intensified mission Indradhanush 3.0. So this was recently launched. The purpose behind it, you can understand, because of the COVID, the vaccination drive for under the Indradhanush, which was the drive which provide the vaccination to the children below the years of 2 and the pregnant women, was also hampered. So that is why it has been envisioned, or it has been highlighted by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, that the mission should again come into a more intensified form, and it should try to provide coverage to the children and the pregnant women under the intensified mission Indradhanush. The version is 3.0. So just remember that part. Now let's just quickly see what it's there. So the focus of IMI 3.0 will be on children and pregnant women who missed their vaccine doses during the COVID-19 pandemic. So just remember that part, that what is the main purpose why 3.0 is now launched, is to actually focus on the children and pregnant women who missed the vaccination dose during the COVID-19. So you must remember that during COVID-19, we were under the lockdown, and the health infrastructure in general is very much stressed. Because of it, what happened, even the hospitals were not able to provide them with the regular doses. So that is something, that is why it becomes important that they are immunized at the earliest. To strengthen and re-energize the program and achieve full immunization coverage for all the children and the pregnant women at the rapid pace, the Government of India launched Mission Indradhanush in the December 2014. So when the first version was launched, it was actually in 2014 when the Mission Indradhanush was launched first. And what is the purpose? The purpose is that full immunization cover. So we are talking about that every child and pregnant women, whatever the vaccination has been approved under the plan, they are vaccinated by it. So this is the idea, this is the motive or the focus for which the Mission Indradhanush was launched in 2014. Then its second variant also came. So its second variant came in 2017. To further intensify the immunization program, Pradhan Mantri Narendra Modi launched the intensified mission in 2017. Again, what the target? So with this, the government aims to reach each and every child up to 2 years of age, and all those pregnant women who have been left uncovered under the routine immunization program or our universal immunization program. So we also have universal immunization program under which the vaccine is provided to the children and pregnant women. Just in case if some women, because of accessibility, because of any other reason, or children because of some reason are not being covered under it, they would be the one who would be targeted, and the aim is to reach the full immunization. So just remember these things. It was launched in 2015. Second variant came in 2017. Again, the purpose was to cover and provide full immunization coverage to the children up to the age of 2 and pregnant women under the universal immunization program, who could have been left out over there. Okay. So let's just quickly see what are the diseases covered under the Indradhanush mission. Now at times, UPSC or non-IAS exam of UPSC, at times they do ask about the diseases. In IAS, you don't see much, but you never know, in a match the following type of question, you could expect some of these diseases. So in that case, just remember the name. You don't have to like by heart it, but the more you see it, the more you will be able to at least eliminate. So what are these? There are 12 vaccine preventable diseases which are included under the program. So these are the diseases for which the vaccination is provided. What are those? This is diphtheria, whooping cough, tetanus, polio, tuberculosis, hepatitis B, meningitis, pneumonia, Haemophilus influenza type B infection, Japanese encephalitis, rotavirus vaccine, pneumonical conjugate vaccine, and the measles rubella. So these are the 12 vaccines which are covered under, or 12 diseases which are covered under the Indradhanush mission for which the vaccine is provided. So just remember the name. However, the vaccination against the Japanese encephalitis and the Haemophilus influenza type B is being provided in selected districts of the country. So basically that is the thing, this is only provided in the selected district. In fact, if you remember, way back in the 2019 in the prelims examination, there was a question which actually, if you would have known that there is a vaccine for hepatitis B, you would have been able to get the answer. So in that regard, just keep an eye on all kind of vaccinations which have been provided under the universal immunization program as well as the Mission Antardhanush. So I hope you have understood this video. If you have any doubt, feel free to drop a comment. Thank you.